Warning. Chloric acid is a highly corrosive and dangerous oxidizer. It breaks down into toxic chlorine dioxide gas, which is extremely unstable and explosive. Only use reasonably small quantities and work in a well-ventilated area. In the world of chemistry, there is a list of chemicals that are considered too dangerous to have practical purpose. Right up there on that list is chloric acid. Of all the chemicals I've worked with, chloric acid is by far the most unhandleable and unpleasant of the bunch. I could just tell you my reasoning behind this statement, but why tell you when I can just show you? To get chloric acid, we first need a chlorate compound. Chlorates don't have a whole lot of uses, and they aren't super accessible unless you have an electrolysis cell, or like me, a whole bunch of matches. Match heads are primarily potassium chlorate, which can be easily extracted by cutting off the match heads and boiling them in water for a few minutes. It's important to use boiling water because potassium chlorate is hundreds of times more soluble when hot. You can then filter off the insoluble junk and keep the liquid, which contains most of the chlorates along with whatever dyes are in the match heads. Now, let's make some chloric acid. To do this, we'll just need to add some sulfuric acid to our chlorate solution. After adding the acid, we begin to get a sense of why chloric acid isn't made that often. The dyes that are in solution are immediately destroyed, leaving only this yellow color. If you're new to chemistry, yellow tends to be a bad thing. The solution also spews out this nasty gas and starts sounding like we just dripped water into some hot oil. At this point, we should be mildly concerned. The yellow color and crackling sound are caused by the formation of chlorine dioxide, which is an explosive yellow gas that smells kind of like chlorine, but more sweet and less sharp. Fortunately, the solution we have here is fairly dilute and it's just handleable enough to try some experiments with. First off, let's check the acid strength with a fairly standard unit of measure, the paper napkin. As we can see, the acid behaves kind of like a weak piranha solution and immediately deconstructs our piece of paper. At higher concentrations, this reaction is a bit more explosive since chloric acid tends to release chlorine dioxide when it gets excited, and hot chlorine dioxide likes to explode. The dilute acid also appears to char sugar, but this might just be the excess sulfuric acid talking. It also has little to no reaction with copper until it is heated, at which point it oxidizes the copper into grayish-black copper oxide. Somewhat surprisingly, it doesn't seem to have any reaction with the red phosphorus on these matched striker pads. I even tried adding the acid to methanol, but there was no visible reaction. Overall, the dilute chloric acid doesn't actually seem that bad. But instead of playing it safe and ending the video on a boring note, I decided it was time to do something that I'd classify as moderately stupid. That's right, it's time to scale up to unreasonably large quantities. To do this, we simply get 6 matchbooks worth of potassium chlorate, dissolve it out, boil it down, and get these nice crystals of potassium chlorate. Then we start dripping in the acid. This is pretty bad. So yeah, it seems like the more concentrated chloric acid is destroying the dyes in solution much more violently and with a whole lot more chlorine dioxide formation. Look at all that yellow. Now do you understand what I mean by unhandleable? Okay, so let's stop just looking at it and try a few more reactions. First up, let's try methanol again. This time, we can see some liquid wicking up the sides of the beaker. This could just be the methanol, but it might also be some kind of reaction product. Probably not, but still. Anyways, next we have sulfur. I was hoping to see some kind of reaction, but nothing happened, even after I hit it with my blowtorch. Finally, I tried a reactant I knew would give me some kind of decent reaction. Magnesium. And as you can see, chloric acid doesn't hesitate to show its hatred for reactive metals. The chlorine dioxide also seems to have ignited a small amount of hydrogen gas, but it's kind of hard to see unless you slow down the footage. Anyways, there you have it, chloric acid and chlorine dioxide from matches. I hope you enjoyed this little excursion into the world of useless and mildly unstable chemistry. If you did, feel free to like, share, and subscribe, and if you'd like to support my work, consider donating or becoming my patron on Patreon. I think I'll be needing the extra money soon, since my old chemistry backdrop will probably need replacing after being messed up by the splattered chloric acid. Until next time, LabCoatz out.